Are there areas of research and just understanding how the stuff works, not applying it, that you would say, this is too dangerous, scientists shouldn't go there?
Certainly, things like working with human embryos, especially with the intent of implanting them to create a pregnancy, that's an area where we need a lot of regulation and caution because there are obvious ethical and societal implications of that kind of work. Same with environmental applications of something like genome editing. If you're going to be releasing insects into the environment that have been edited, and especially if they have the ability to pass their genetic traits on to other others in their population that might affect the whole population, I think that's, again, something that needs to be handled with appropriate caution.
Because you're beta testing the ecosystem at that point.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
The potential to do incredible things and make incredible advances that will be beneficial to our society, but hand in hand with that goes these large risks. So, you know, week by week, I find that, you know, my field is changing. The technology is advancing rapidly. So that's one thing, obviously hard even as a scientist to keep up with it, much less if you're a, you know, a policymaker.
It sounds like you're saying there are these momentous applications that we've already seen, but it sounds like you really believe that the big ones that cause the greatest amount of death, early, you know, premature death in the human population, heart disease, cancers across the body, you think this will be meaningful for all of those in the fairly near future?
Yeah, I mean, I'm an optimist, but I'm trying to be appropriately cautious here. I think realistically, however, you know, for the foreseeable future, it will continue to be the case that in most, you know, in most situations, we're going to want to use CRISPR in individuals, not to create heritable changes in the DNA, but really to treat an individual. And I'm anticipating a time when it will be possible, for example, to protect people from diseases that they might otherwise be susceptible to. So, for example, so imagine that we could eventually use genome editing to protect people from getting certain forms of dementia that might otherwise, you know, they would succumb to because of their genetics. I think that would be an incredible advance.
Well, because we talk about healthcare, but of course, in reality, what we're spending most of our money on is sick care. It's response to people that already have maladies. And what you're saying is the ability to create these immunities to build up the ability of human bodies on an individual basis to resist these kinds of diseases, that's what CRISPR is going to be most effective at.
That's right. Exactly.